Hey Jer, I loved your video. I loved the analogy of being out fighting a fire and the fire station burns down and how that equates to our country nowadays. You bring up a very interesting point about McCain, one that, because of political correctness, I hadn't really gone there. And I wonder sometimes if that is a mistake, because maybe we do need to go there. Certainly in the case of McCain, McCain will be one of the oldest presidents that we elect, if he's elected. And you're right. As you get older, you think a lot about the past. There's not as much a focus on the future. Now, in relative terms, I'm still relatively young. I do sometimes think about the future, my future, the world's future, but I often drift back into the past. Because I've been successful in my professional career, I will oftentimes fall back on what's worked before, the tried and the true, where I'm comfortable. And as you get older, it's more and more difficult to step outside your comfort zone. Not quite as sure. That's where young people come in. That's what makes them so vital to a country, because they can step in, take a chance, try something we haven't tried, and they're willing to give it a go. I worry about McCain being that candidate that spends time in the past, in the Cold War, in the failures of our past administrations, and the war machine. See, that's what happens when you get in a war. The idea is you go someplace and you kill other people. That's the whole concept of a war. That's why we very, very carefully should consider whether we go to war. And in our recent past, we haven't gone to war. We've had several incursions. We had an occupation of another country in Iraq. But it's been a long time since our Congress and our country declared war on another country in the way the Constitution wanted us to. I don't know what Obama will bring, other than, as you said, some of that hope. And is that such a bad thing? I mean, really, when it comes right down to it. You know, we know that the president has some power. There are things that he can do, and things that he really can't do. And if the president has good oversight from the Congress and the Senate and the judicial system, which we've had none of in the last 8 years, then there's a balance of power. I don't know, is it such a bad thing to have hope that things could change? And when, the other thing that really bothers me is, when did the United States become so afraid that they were unwilling to step out and hope and change? When did we get to the point where we were so timid and so scared that we can't think about the possibility of change, because change is just too scary in this world that we live in? We better leave things just the way they are, because it's a scary world out there. Things haven't been working too good the way we've done them, but gosh, what would it be like if we changed? I mean, what does that mean, we're going to change? And we get scared. When did the United States of America become scared of change? It almost seems sometimes that the United States is willing to give up its leadership position in the world because we fear change and we don't want to do things any differently. I don't know when that happened, but I'm hoping that there'll be some people that will be willing to put aside their fear and say, let's go for it. Let's go for it. Let's try this change. We shall see. Great video, Jer.